Hello there, my name is Matthias. I'm a solo traveler from Germany, and today I'd like to show you a place that is quite special for me because I grew up here. Welcome to the Münsterland, a region in Germany's west. This place is known for its flat landscapes, for its small villages and for its horses, because the equestrian sport is quite popular here in the Münsterland. But if you're not interested in that, which I would understand, there's much more to see here. For example, quiet nature reserves, old historic towns and hundreds of castles, and that's what I'd like to show you today. Here are three great travel tips for a day in Germany's Münsterland. And here's my first travel tip. Steinfurt, a small town with around 30,000 residents and beautiful old houses like these. The textile industry, to be precise, the linen weaving, was an important part of Steinfurt's history. This industry still shapes the architecture of the city today. You will find many old buildings here, small alleys and cozy restaurants where you can spend the day. But the most interesting place of Steinfurt might be the old castle, Burg Steinfurt. It's a ring-shaped building that was first mentioned in 1129. It's considered to be the oldest water castle in Westphalia. It stands on a circular island and around it the tributary Ahr flows. Here you will also find an old water mill in the same architectural style. Right next to the castle, in 1338, the first market settlement was built, which later became the town of Steinfurt. The castle Burg Steinfurt today is still private property, so unfortunately you cannot visit it from inside. But there is a huge park right next to the castle, where you can take a walk around it and watch the impressive architecture. Tip number 2. Tecklenburg. This town lies on the edge of the Münsterland, right next to the Teutoburg forest. The city doesn't just have one single half-timbered castle, no, the entire town looks like that. You will find dozens of old half-timbered houses here that were built between the 16th and the 18th century. There is also a historic castle here, which was built around 1100. To get there, you have to walk up a small hill, and from above, you will have a stunning view over the town. A highlight in Tecklenburg is also the moated castle Haus Mark, which is known for its castle concerts, and there are also a few museums here, for example the Otto Modersohn Museum, the Culture House or the Doll Museum. Every year traditional festivals are held in Tecklenburg, like the Geranium Market or the Linen Market or the Christmas Market in December, and also a wine festival is celebrated here every year. But this one thing Tecklenburg is most famous for is actually its open-air theater. Every summer, thousands of tourists are coming to Tecklenburg to see stage plays like The Wizard of Oz, Sister Act and many more. And here's my third and last travel tip for today. The Bockholt Hills in Greven. This place is a nature reserve with extensive dune landscapes and pink heath flowers. Let me show you a few pictures I took in summer. In August and September, this whole landscape turns into a sea of colors. But also in spring, this place is worth a visit. Until 1850, this area consisted of open heathland, but then trees were planted here, so that's why there is a mixture of both today. The sand dunes with heather and dry grass are habitats for many rare plants. Also, many animal species that are endangered and extremely rare live in the Bockholt Hills area, such as the woodlark, the kingfisher, the black woodpecker, the sand lizard, and also insects such as tiger beetles and sand wasps can be found in this sandy area. And for visitors like you and me, there is a hiking trail that you can walk and where you can learn everything about the flora and fauna in this area. Okay, that was my trip to the Münsterland. I hope you liked it. I hope you liked my travel tips. If you did, please leave a thumbs up. You can also hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you won't miss any upcoming travel video. And if you'd like to support me and my work, check out the Patreon link in the description. That's it for today. Have a safe journey and see you next time.